Well, as of yesterday and today, it wasn't great. Back is one thing that can be very tricky when it goes off, and it happened at the later half or last leg of the South Africa tour when I missed a T20 game, because that was very sudden. It happened one day before, but the good thing is I have 5 days before the next test, and we're confident with rehab and strengthening. I should be ready for the next game, although not the same intensity in the field, but you know, I should be good enough to hold a position in the field and be 100% with the bat. Again, I'll have to look at the running bit of things, which was difficult today. But yeah, as of now, it's sore. You know, not hiding that fact, but that's part of the game. I mean, I had to do whatever I could to go out there and bat again, and you know, try my best. So yeah, 5 days is, I think, a good enough time to be ready for the next test.
Virat, it might sound bitter, the thing is that, you know, it's only one man on Virat Kohli. And if he fails, again, it sounds bitter, the team collapses. How long will it continue?
We definitely as a team don't and cannot think from that point of view. As I said last time around, it's no one's doing anyone a favor by going out there and performing. It's our job to do that, and it's a duty that we've been given. We've been selected to play for the country, and what we did in this game, we should definitely be better than that. I'm the first one who will come out and accept that, because unless you accept your mistake, you can't improve on it, and you can't get better, and you can't have a chance of competing in the next game if you want to, you know, level the series and win the game. So we definitely have to accept what we did wrong. There's no hiding from the fact that mistakes have been made. We'll have to accept those, put them on the side, learn from them, and make sure that we're not thinking about the same mistakes again, rather get more confident and get ahead of the mistake and not repeat it again. So that's our immediate focus heading to the next game. We're not, certainly not thinking of anything else but to go 2-1 in the series, and you know, from there on, build on that strongly, because this is the first time in the last 5 tests that we've been really outplayed. You know, we haven't been outplayed, we've competed in every game. So we'll have to accept that a side like England, when they play like that, they can outplay any opposition, especially when they play at home and you know, the ball's doing a bit. So we'll have to accept that, put it on the side, and improve in the next game. Well, we're not, certainly not thinking about what happened the last time around that we came here, 2014 or 11. We're only thinking about the fact that we do have the bowling attack to pick up 20 wickets. And as batsmen, we should think of that as an opportunity to score runs and, you know, make the team win games. What's been unfortunate, or I wouldn't say unfortunate, what's been sad is that we haven't got those two skills coming together. I don't think it's unfortunate totally, because you can't rely on fortune and luck in every game that you play. You literally have to go out there and work hard and try to get ahead of the situation that you're in. We haven't been able to do that consistently. If the bowlers have done well, the batsmen have not been able to step up. Joburg was one game where both skills came together and we ended up winning. So I think that's what we need. We need that balance. We need guys putting their hands up and saying, okay, give me a tough situation and I'm going to pull the team out. You know, it's as I said before the game, it's all in the head. It's nothing to do with the game. You can play well in any condition if you're mentally ready for it. And that's something that we need to work on over the next 4 or 5 days. We should want the next test match to come early rather than thinking, oh, we have 5 days till the test match comes on. So these are small little things that make a massive difference. And again, as I said, as a team, we'll do everything that we can to get into that frame of mind and go to Nottingham and think of starting well and with intensity. Well, see, I mean, when you start the game, you obviously think positive. You feel like you're ready for the game, and every batsman thinks that way. It's, you know, when you're out there in a situation which is tough, you have to find ways of countering that situation, which I think we have failed to do as batsmen, myself included in this game. We haven't been able to have partnerships, which is the basic rule while batting. We haven't had any sort of partnerships in this game. Only 50 with Hardik and Ash this innings. Nothing of any substance before or after that. So that is something that we need to really focus on. You know, stringing in partnerships, making sure we get to 60, 70, 80, 80 run partnership, and then trying to build that into a big partnership, or have 3 or 4 small little partnerships of 60 or 70 odd, and you know, put this team in a strong position. I think when you look too far ahead, thinking the score isn't enough or, you know, there are wickets on the board, that can pressurize a batsman. But if you're focused on adding 5 runs at a time or, you know, building that partnership slowly but surely, that's how you come out of a difficult situation. It's something that we've experienced in the past as well. And for that, we need to find ways of doing it. There's no running from it. There's no hiding from it. As I said last time around, you know, everything that you think or you feel is on the field. It's out there. And it's upon us to turn it around and get positive for the next game and believe that the first game we lost by 30 runs. This game we've been outplayed. We've got to put this behind us and come into the third game as we were in the first game in that frame of mind. And when the situation arises, we've got to step up and take control of the situations which we failed to do so far. Well, look, I mean, any chances given to the guys at any position, they have to make sure that they step up and grab them. Right now, it's not, you know, purely thinking that the openers haven't fired or, you know, the middle order hasn't done well, because as a batting unit, we haven't done well in this game as a whole. So it's very difficult to, you know, pinpoint one area. All we have to do is gear up for the next game, as I said, come out positive and not think about whether I've done well or whether the openers have done well or the middle order has done well or not. It's all about making the team win and doing anything that we can to make that happen. Even if we are 10 for 2, it doesn't mean that the guys following after should just succumb, because that's a part of the game. And we should not expect sitting in the change room that we'll only bat at 100 for 2. You know, we have to look forward to the difficult situation and trying to make that into a good situation, taking responsibility of the you know, scenario that's out there in the middle. So I think it's wrong to sit down and expect a situation to be a certain way. You have to react to how the situation pans out. That's the nature of this game, and we have to take responsibility of that. As I said, I don't see any technical deficiencies. If a batsman is clear in the head and he's clear about the plans that he's taking out in the middle, and then if the ball does something off the pitch, you're in a position to counter it. As a batsman, as I said, I've experienced that in the past. If my head's clouded, then I feel like the ball can do this or that or even that. You know, the 3-4 scenarios that run in your head. So, as you know, it sounds cliche, but as the greats have said, keep this game simple, and that's all you have to do. You can't come here and think the conditions are too difficult, because they're really not. If you're prepared to counter them, any condition in the world can be easy or as difficult. As I said, in India, if you're not mentally there, it seems like the ball's doing a whole lot, even when it's not. So, as I said, the focus has to be what the team requires and not, you know, what individual games need to be. So all I can say here is we're going to try our level best to get into that frame of mind where we're thinking team all the time. And then the intent will come through. You know, we'll be scoring runs, we'll be taking on the bowling, and we'll be showing more intent with the bat, which is what is required from next game onwards.
So as far as you are concerned, it's all in the head, you're saying?
Yeah. As I said in the pre-match as well, I can't speak for an individual. This is what I have experienced in the past and which has clouded my mind. I'm not saying that is happening with others, to be very clear about it. It's something that as a batsman has put doubt in my game in the past. So I'm saying the only thing that can work and which does work is being very clear and blank in your head and then reacting to what the ball is doing rather than expecting it to do something. That's all I'm saying.